Hello, hi, how are you? I'm Robin. Welcome back or welcome to my YouTube channel. This little world right here is Man From South, but this little world right here is Covent Garden in London. Now I am working with Penhaligon's, who are about to let me loose in their Wellington Street store. There's no one else around, so I do get to keep my mask off. I'm gonna take you through maybe five, maybe push a six of the most iconic Penhaligon's fragrances. Now, for fragrance lovers like you and me, this is like a playground. It's a sensory delight. The bottles look amazing. It smells beautiful in here. And it's definitely something you should check out. Now, Penhaligon's has quite the history. For me, it's like the best of British. It was established in 1870 by William Penhaligon, who was a humble barber, who then went on to create some absolutely beautiful fragrances and passed the brand down through the family. Now, I want to take you on a bit of a fragrance journey with this one. So it's like it's a sit back, relax, get a coffee, because these are some of the Penhaligon's fragrances that you should be trying. Right, let's start. I've already seen one of my favorites there. Let's start with Quercus. Now, this is very much a unisex fragrance, but I would say, you know, all fragrances are unisex. Wear what you like, wear what smells good in your skin. If you like a citrus, and when I say citrus, I mean like a huge citrus poppy blast up your beak, then this could be the one for you. Oof. This has got lemon, lime, mandarin, and bergamot in the top. So really, it's all those good, juicy citrus fruits. Into the heart, there's just a dash of floral with jasmine, a hint of spice with black pepper. But really, it's when you start to wear this that you'll smell the dry down, and what I really like on the skin, and what makes it really a little bit more wearable, there's musk, there's amber, and there's the warming wood of sandalwood. Okay, next. Let's give you a little bit of a story time here. Maybe we can get some story time music on. This is Endymion. Now, my Greek mythology is a little bit limited, but I know this one. Endymion was a son of Zeus, and it's said that he was a very handsome shepherd who kind of lived a life of perpetual sleep. So I don't think he was lazy, but he certainly liked a little downtime. And he fell in love with Selene, who was the goddess of the moon. And over time, she gave him 50 daughters. So he was busy, and I can see why. This smells amazing. This is completely different from everything else. This is comforting, it's sexy, it's sensual, it's sultry. When I first smelt this, I literally just had to have a moment, take a step back, have a sniff, and really get into it. I love smelling this on someone else. Celine loved it, I love it. It's absolutely gorgeous. Now this has got notes of bergamot, suede, coffee, and geranium. If you do get stuck with fragrance, and I think we all do, you know, it's quite hard sometimes to find what suits you, the kind of things you like. Is it spicy? Is it floral? Is it citrus? Penhaligon's do have a fragrance profiling service, which is really on their site or in store. You can answer a few questions to find the type of fragrance that you might like to wear. This one here is one of Penhaligon's best sellers, and I think it's no surprise that this is in their top list. This is Halfetti. Now, Halfetti is a statement fragrance. It's a fragrance that I know quite a few people that wear, but it smells so different on everyone else. Now, I have worn this myself, and I've also covered it on manfromself.com and also on the channel, so you might have heard me talking about this before. Now, although there is a citrus opening, for me, and I'm sure for you guys too, this is all about the statement rose. Now, rose you might think of being overtly floral, a bit whimsical, maybe too feminine, but so much weight has been added to this. With leather, there's also oud and warming woods. This is statement, it's rich, and I'm gonna go so far as to say it's wickedly self-indulgent. Now, unlike a lot of the fragrances, if you like something, you can start to layer it with a bath and body oil or a body and hand wash. If you wanna get yourself a little deal, then I've managed to get you a code. Now, this is the Penhaligon Scent Library, 10 little gorgeous minis to try before you go for a big one. And if you spend over £60 on Penhaligon's, I'll link it down below in the description, you'll get yourself a little scent library for free. This one is Sartorial. I actually put this up on my Instagram stories last night, and I had maybe six guys reply, hi, if that was you, saying that this was their fragrance. This one to me is like the perfect tailored suit. It's crisp, it's sharp, it's like a business deal. It's like deal, 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 like give me that job, give me what I want. It's so commanding. This takes inspiration from Norton & Sons, which is a Savile tailor. So it's from their back room, their workroom. So there is quite a mix of the notes. There's a note of steam in here. Now you might think, what does steam smell like? This is called an ozonic note. So really it's kind of, it's a smell of something that's in the air. There's also beeswax, so it gives it a slight creaminess, a touch of leather, and there's also a lavender in this. So if you're a guy that, or a girl, hi, who wants to smell good, wants to smell confident, but doesn't want anything too shouty, then this could be the sharp suit for you. Right, let's go from dapper gent to a gin and tonic over here. Welcome to the Man For Himself bar. Do you fancy yourself a little gin and tonic? I certainly do. And this is what I absolutely love about this fragrance. Now, much like a good gin and tonic, I am a bit of a gin and tonic connoisseur. Juniper Sling is refreshing and thirst quenching. Now, you've got the juniper berries in there, which playfully dance on the nose, but you've also got cooling cardamom and black pepper. So there is just a bit of spice in there, which keeps it going. I would say with this one, it is so easy to wear and just as easily worn in the sort of brighter spring and summer as some of those sort of cooler months like now into autumn, winter. I did think maybe do 5, but I'm in here now. Let's maybe get you into a 6. Let's do Lofer. This is also part of the Trade Roots collection. We saw Hoffetti earlier. This is another one from that same collection. So if you do want something a little bit more exotic, something a bit spicy, something which I think of all these sort of Trade Roots ones could be like your signature scent. These are calling cards. Now, Lofer, much like Juniper Sling, has juniper in it. There's also red berries, which I think give it a slight sort of like winter sort of quality. There's also two types of fig in here. There's fig leaf and there's also fig milk. You've got your chocolate milk, you've got your strawberry milk, you've got your fig milk. No, but with fig, I often think it's kind of got a bit of like a meaty woodiness to it. There's something with heart. You kind of want to take like a good bite into it. This one is, it's got a slight creaminess to it, but it's also so distinctive. Much like these other fragrances, like you're not gonna get them mixed up. Now this one, I think, like perfectly goes with this suit. It's distinctive, it's a bit shouty, it's outgoing, it's confident. It wants a bit of attention with this. So it's definitely not for the faint-hearted, but I think with any sort of fragrances, when you're building your fragrance wardrobe, it's great to have those lighter ones with like the Quercus, the Juniper Sling. You've got something slightly heavier with your Trade Roots of Lofer or Halfetti, or just a great crisp suit with Sartorial. So there you go. What would have been 5, but I always like to push it. 6 of the most iconic Penhaligon's fragrances. I've said it before, I'll say it again. Like if you get me into a fragrance store, I'm gonna go wild. This I absolutely love. This is like my sort of like heaven, my adult playground right here. So do check out the fragrances. They'll all be linked below in the description. Also, there is the fragrance profiling. So if you're a bit stuck, you're not too sure what you want to do, Penhaligon's will be able to help you out. Also, push this one, your exclusive code. If you want to get yourself that little scent library, then you can check that out below. But thank you again for watching. Really hope you've enjoyed this one. I certainly have. If you're still new to my channel, you've still not pressed subscribe, and you're still stuck it out to the end, then please do press subscribe right now. The button is just there, probably be just above the fragrance. There's also more video suggestions down there. A link to the fragrance pages on manforhimself.com. All of these Penhaligon's fragrances are there. And yeah, that's your lot. But until my next video, bye-bye.